Yeah, how often do you stop and think, wait a minute, that can't be right. My mind must be playing tricks on me. Well, the National Geographic Channel has found this smash hit in a show called Brain Games, and I got a chance to talk with host Jason Silva, who showed me what's really going on inside our heads. I am really excited to have you on the program. I watch the show. A lot of people watch the show, I know. It's fascinating, and before we get into some of the specifics, how did you get interested in this?
Sure. Well, I've always been like a really curious person. I love science, I love technology, I love the human capacity to transcend boundaries, and we do that with the brain, which is the most complicated object in the universe. Everything starts with the brain. At the same time, though, we shouldn't get cocky, because the brain does have these fixed limitations.
Right.
And so what's exciting about Brain Games is that we create these interactive experiments, these participatory games that people at home can actually play along with that highlight your misperceptions of reality. And I think that, you know, makes you feel a sense of humility, a sense of wonder, a sense of curiosity as to the ambiguity of our perceptions. People learn by doing, you know.
It's really mind-blowing, literally, sometimes.
Mind-blowing, exactly, yes.
Let's take a look at a couple of them.
Super.
I think that the idea, again, the limitations of our brain.
Right.
And the idea that our brain is going to start to take shortcuts to fill in things.
Exactly.
Let's
so here, stare at that dot and focus on that dot. Ignore the rest of the image. So you keep focusing on the dot. What's happening is, okay, so did you notice that for a second it looked like that picture was a color picture?
It actually did.
So what happened
show it again while
yeah,
we're
show it
talking.
Again. Okay. Great. So what was happening when you're staring at this dot, we're actually tiring your color receptors. And so what's happening is that they're getting fatigued. And then when the actual image becomes a normal black and white image, your brain is filling in those colors. That was never a color image. That was your brain rendering that a color image.
Put an exclamation mark on that. We did nothing to that photograph.
We did nothing
to that.
That's
a black and white photograph.
100%.
One more example in case you don't believe us.
Yeah.
Let's take a look.
So stare at the dot again. And again, that's tiring your color receptors. You keep staring at it.
Wow.
And it looked like a color beach.
A beautiful
and
beach scene.
Before your very eyes, it goes black and white. It was never a color photograph. That was your brain that did that. And I guess the takeaway there is the reminder that reality, what we call reality, is a co-production between the limited signals you get from your brain, and then you get from the world, and your brain filling in the blanks. Like with our eyes, we can only actually perceive low-res 2D images. We go about the world, it's 3D, it's high-res, our brain is up-converting.
Filling a lot of that
100%.
In. 100%. That's how we get by, and we trust that.
We trust that very much, and you know, we're usually pretty good at it, but what this show is meant to do is highlight the ways in which sometimes we miss a step.
Wasn't a color picture.
Exactly.
Patterns, this is something that you guys do a lot on the show, and sometimes
definitely.
In the form of brain teasers and stuff like that. I'm probably putting myself on the spot here. But maybe you can give us a few and just
absolutely.
Explain.
Absolutely. You know, there's a great line. It says, to understand is to perceive patterns, right? That
right.
is what it means to be human.
Well, it's interesting because from an evolutionary standpoint, you wanted to recognize patterns, and you wanted to recognize when something fell out of a pattern because that could be a threat.
That could be 100% a threat. That's why we're so nervous all the time. Overactive amygdalas in the brain, always afraid, always getting stressed, you know?
Right.
So let me give you an example of a kind of a riddle. And your brain, again, is looking very quickly for a pattern and looking for completing that pattern,
okay.
often erroneously. So there's a funny one. Mary's mother has four daughters, April, May, June, and?
Now, I know there's you want to say July. That's
right.
not the answer.
Right.
Mary's mother has four daughters,
yeah.
April, May, June. And Mary.
All right. Now that is very, very smart what you just did because you broke it down. You actually listened to the whole question. But you also know that your inclination was to answer and fill in the pattern. You heard April, May, June. Well, July comes there. But
right.
wait a minute. What was the question? The question was Mary's mother has four daughters. So imagine you go throughout your life, throughout the world, you're filling in patterns all the time. You're making assumptions about the world that are very, very quick without often looking at the whole picture.
It's fascinating. It really
totally.
Is. And again, this is a glimpse into the brain that many people never get to see. We just take this stuff for granted.
Completely.
I'm a fan of yours.
I'm a fan of yours.
We got a dollar bill, I think, for you that we're gonna. You got something you got to do with the dollar bill?
Oh yes.
This is not your parting present.
No. Yeah. So this is one of those game. This is one of those brain games that looks at lag time in your brain's decision to perform a physical action and then telling your body to go and do it.
Okay.
So this is called the bill drop. If you put your finger like this, your hand like that. Now you would think that the minute that I decide to let go of that dollar bill, you have plenty of time to clinch it and not drop it. But because of the lag time, I'm not going to tell you when I'm going to let go, but you just have to pay attention. As soon as I let go, you have to close your fingers.
No, it's I'm one losing of the money left and right.
Exactly.
Here.
But we could do that 10 times, and every single time it would go through, because by the time you notice me letting go and you tell your hand close, that's already a lag time.
I was faster than that.
Yeah, totally. Most of us do, but that's one of those funny games. So anyway.
Stay in touch.
Oh, thank
Come
you.
Back anytime.
Oh, thanks for having me. Such a pleasure, Sanjay.
Thank you.
Thanks.